Hey, my friends, welcome back. I'm Dr. Christine Bradstreet of Change Your Mind, Change Your Life, and you come here to learn how you can overcome neuroplastic pain, otherwise known as mind-body pain and symptoms, or TMS, tension myositis syndrome. As we know, it's human nature and pretty much automatic to blame our physical pains and physical symptoms on physical things, such as injuries, overexertion, age of the body, foods that we eat, physical conditions around us. It's only natural that we do that, but if you've been studying the mind-body conditions, neuroplastic symptoms and pain coming to channels like this, you've learned at least intellectually that even though these symptoms and conditions feel very physical, they're the result of a wiring change within the brain, connections with the brain that are misinterpreting normal healthy signals. However, as you know, the symptoms feel so physical that we can have this intellectual knowledge, but sometimes still like not quite be convinced. So you're a little bit on the fence as far as where your symptoms or your pain are coming from. So today what we're gonna do is build an evidence sheet or an evidence table. The reason why we're doing this is so that you can reinforce to your brain proof, evidence that your symptoms or your pain are neuroplastic, not from a physical condition. The more evidence you can provide your conscious thinking brain, eventually your subconscious mind will follow suit and begin to have it be second nature, or for lack of a better word, believable to you that your symptoms are neuroplastic and not physical. It might be helpful for you to pause this video right now and grab a notebook, a piece of paper, something where you can begin your evidence sheet, your list of evidence that your symptoms are neuroplastic. And I'm going to go through some of the common clues that are proof to you that your symptoms or your pain are neuroplastic, are from the mind-body condition. If you like, go grab a piece of paper. Otherwise, just listen to the video in its entirety and then repeat it later when you have time to build your list. Here is your proof that your symptoms are neuroplastic or mind-body, or what some people call TMS. And forgive me, I'm going to occasionally look down at my list and read them to you. Your symptoms began without a physical injury. So just maybe over time, your hip, your back, your knee, your shoulder started aching, or headaches developed, or upset stomachs developed, but without a physical injury. Or you had an injury, but several weeks or months have passed and you still don't feel better. So in the amount of physical time it takes for the injury to heal, that has passed, but you still have your symptoms. That's evidence that this is neuroplastic pain. Symptoms are in a distribution pattern that are symmetrical, both arms, both legs, both sides of your back. Or symptoms occur all on the right side, all on the left side. These are clues that your symptoms are neuroplastic. Over time, symptoms have spread to various parts of the body. Well, it used to be in the low back, and then it changed to the sacroiliac joint, and then it changed to the hip, and then it was your knee. Or as soon as your back pain cleared up, you started getting headaches. And as soon as your headaches cleared up, you started getting symptoms of IBS. So traveling symptoms are a very strong indicator of neuroplastic symptoms. Or similarly, symptoms that occur in many different parts of the body at the same time. You got all these things going on at once. That's just an indication that your brain is very bombarded with fearful messages and misinterpreting normal signals from your body as pain when really they are not. Certain sensations like burning, tingling, hot, cold, creepy crawly sensations of tension, these are all common sensations that the brain makes up, creates in neuroplastic symptoms. More evidence that your symptoms are neuroplastic is that it's inconsistent. You feel great for part of the day, lousy for another part of the day. You wake up in a lot of pain, but for some reason it goes away throughout the day, or the opposite. You wake up feeling great, and for some reason it starts up during the day. Symptoms occur after physical exertion and not during it. Symptoms that either show up or intensify when you recreate or think about a stressful situation. Similarly, symptoms that decrease or go away when you're just having fun, having a good time, maybe laughing with friends or watching a funny movie, something like that. These are all inconsistencies that go on your evidence sheet that to reassure yourself that your symptoms are neuroplastic and not physical. Symptoms that are helped temporarily by going for some forms of treatment, electrical muscle stimulation, taking a vitamin, getting a massage, getting Reiki, whatever it is that you are looking for symptom relief. If this gives you some temporary relief and then the symptoms just come back again, great indication that this is a neuroplastic symptom and not actually from a physical condition. More items for your evidence sheet that this is neuroplastic and not physical. Symptoms are triggered by things that don't affect the physical body, like the weather, a full moon, the time of the day, the time of the year as far as seasonality, foods, smells, scents and perfumes, sounds, lights. These things don't actually affect the physical body, but your brain has developed an association and your brain is convinced that these things are dangerous, that these things need to be avoided, and so your brain is triggering symptoms to avoid these things. Symptoms that are triggered by anticipation, fear, anticipation, anxiety about an upcoming event, something that you need to do, a place you need to go. This anticipatory triggering of symptoms, excellent clue, excellent evidence that your symptoms are neuroplastic and not physical. Symptoms that are triggered by innocent movement, like turning your head or reaching or bending over or eating normal meal. When symptoms are triggered or triggered inconsistently by these things, very good indication that your symptoms are neuroplastic. The body is remarkably tough. You really cannot damage tissue by innocuous movements. Or also symptoms that are triggered by other innocuous things like cold air, a breeze, a light touch, minimal amounts of exertion. Okay, so these are all things to put on your evidence sheet and go through and watch the video a second time so you can take notes as you go. Make a very long list of all these inconsistencies so that over time it becomes just second nature to you, the understanding that these symptoms are neuroplastic and not physical. Now, what do you do with this evidence sheet once you've completed making it? We'll continue to add to it as time goes on, as you discover new little bits and pieces that are like clues, like, aha, like, I got you, brain. I figured out what you're doing. That's an inconsistency. And I'm going to put that on my evidence sheet of evidence that this is not a physical problem and I don't need to be afraid of it. Use your evidence sheet if you happen to have a setback or a day when you are just not feeling well. Read through your evidence sheet to remind you, to reinforce the knowledge and understanding that these symptoms are neuroplastic, they are not dangerous, they are temporary, and that it's just a mixed up signaling issue going on with how your brain and body wired and locked in these sensations. Use your evidence sheet to give you confidence so that you can stand on one side of the fence and not straddle it. Because like we've talked about in the past, if you're straddling the fence using mind-body techniques to rewire your brain, but at the same time seeking out help from outside sources, physical sorts of remedies, you're giving your brain a mixed signal, and then the brain is never going to be convinced to let go of wiring connections that are locking your pain and symptoms into place. So an evidence sheet can be an important step in overcoming neuroplastic pain and symptoms because it's so vitally important that you know without a shadow of a doubt that these are neuroplastic symptoms and that they are nothing more than a signaling issue going on with your brain, a misinterpreting issue, a misinterpreting things as being dangerous, misinterpreting normal sensation as pain sensation, and locking in through memory and association, locking in the symptoms. All right, my friends, thank you for being here. Please hit that subscribe button and give the video a thumbs up if you learned something new, and I'll see you in a couple days. Bye-bye.